Okay. Hope she's being behaved. Her husband doesn't get here until Monday. Okay, we're just about ready, ladies and gentlemen. Antonio Edwards, Cymbalha, and Tony Desario.
We'll find a way of fighting. you, Chicago.
Simba Hall, Antonio Edwards, and Tony DeSario. Now, how was that? See, I told you Simba could still sing. Are you ready to take the mic now? So you got the evening wear.
How are we doing, Chicago? Come on now, I've been upstairs and I ain't heard no hollering all night. I don't know what the problem is. Woo-hoo! I don't know what the problem is, but Simba's on the mic now and I need some action up in here. These boys are doing good tonight. Are y'all enjoying the competition? Hey, amen. Now I need each one of y'all to go home to your local cities because we do want to see the system grow. And if the system grow, you have more choices of men to get tonight. Amen. Don't play with me. Y'all know what y'all looking for. You ready? We're ready for formal wear. Are we ready? It's the last scored category. Moving quickly and professionally, let's bring to the stage, this is contestant number two. He goes by the name of Gavin Dupree Sanchez. Gavin is a Cancer. He's representing Empire State Continental. His hobbies are swimming, traveling, politics, dance, and theater. Formal titles include Mr. Gay Black Ohio, Mr. Cosmopolitan Hot International, Mr. Empire State Continental, and he reigns in New York. If you like what you see, it's okay to put those hands together for Gavin Sanchez. Let's bring to the stage, this is contestant number three. He goes by the name of Javon Andrews. Looking very lovely and debonair. His astrological sign is Pisces. He's representing Jim DeMundo and the Metropolitan Continental. He's also sponsored by Jim DeMundo, What's Happening Magazine, Danielle Hunter, and Revolution Nightclub. His hobbies include dancing, acting, singing, fishing, making friends, and looking good. Put your hands together one more time for Javon Andrews. Now welcome to the stage. This is contestant number seven. He goes by the name of Jose Perez. Jose is a Libra. He's representing Southeast Florida Continental. He's sponsored by Neil Hiley, Revolution Nightclub, Your Bottom Ballroom Studio, Nadia Ballrooms Designers. His hobbies include dance, drawing, makeup, and art. Let's put our hands together one more time. This is Mr. Jose Perez. We got some energy going here. Now we're bringing to the stage, this is contestant number eight. Put your hands together for Mr. Noah Lee Richards. Me and Noah share the same sign. He is a Gemini. He's representing Big Apple Continental. He's sponsored by Sean Fung Aling, Laisha Richards, Tiffany Richards, Chris Mapp, MGM Designs, Big Apple Continental, Gavin Sanchez, family and friends. He is currently an undergrad student majoring in music education with a minor in dance. He'd love to be a Broadway one day. He'd love to open his own dance company. An intelligent man with ambitions. You can put your hands together for Mr. Noah Lee Richard. Ladies and gentlemen, let's welcome to the stage. This is your contestant number 9. He goes by the name of Mr. Christopher Iman. Christopher is a Pisces. He's representing Virginia Icon Continental. Y'all seem to like that. I'ma just let him do all his work. His hobbies include singing, dancing, and playing the piano. Current titles include Virginia Icon and Mr. MSTN, that's Mr. State of Tennessee. I don't have to tell y'all if y'all like what you see. Go on and do what you gotta do. I'll bring it to the stage, ladies and gentlemen. This is your contestant number 10. He goes by the name of Mr. Leo Damore. Leo's astrologer. I can't say that word. His zodiac sign is Capricorn. Amen, somebody. Looking very nice in his gray. He is represented by Mr. Dream Boy Continental. He's sponsored by Antonio King and my wife, Ms. Victoria LePage. What you laugh for, Ginger? His hobbies include shopping, dancing, and eating. Some other titles he hold is Mr. Clubhouse and Mr. Dream Boy Continental. Very nice and debonair. That is number 10, Leo Damore. Now welcome to the stage. This is contestant number 11. He goes by the name of Joel D. Principal. Ooh. Joel is a Gemini. He is representing Heart of America. He's sponsored by Heart of America Townhouse Bar, Brian Charity, Squeeze Designs, One Source LLC, The Principal Dancers, Dragged Out, his mom, many friends and fans of Joel D. Principal. I think he brought all his fans with him on tonight. That's all right, Joel. Hobbies include being creative, designing his own costumes, and hanging with his friends. It's okay, put your hands together one more time for Mr. Joel D. Principal. Bring it to the stage. This is contestant number 12. He goes by the name of Mr. Michael Valentine. Well, all right. Michael is a Cancer. He's also representing Mr. Heart of America. He's sponsored by Stella Productions, his mother, Mr. Heart of America, grandmother, and Mocha Montrese. His hobbies include coaching, cheerleading, gymnastics, painting, reading, traveling, and eating. These boys don't enjoy eating. I enjoy eating. All right, ladies and gentlemen, put your hands together one more time. That is Mr. Michael Valentine. Now, ladies and gentlemen, let's bring to the stage, this is contestant number 15. He goes by the name of Neandre Bonet. Neandre is an Aries. He's representing Shining Star Continental. in Indianapolis, Indiana, my new home. He's sponsored by Randall Smith, India Damore, Shining Star Productions, and R.L. Hobbs. His hobbies include computers, cooking, literature, and astrology. Some of his titles include Mr. Shining Star Continental and Mr. Ebony International. Looking good in his black, that is contestant number 15, Mr. Neandre Bonet. Wrapping out this formal award section, let's put our hands together for the contestant number 16. This is none other than, can I say the name first? Lewis Nicholson. Lewis is a Cancer, representing Mr. State of Florida Continental. He's sponsored by Scott Holland, Greg Ullman, Douglas, Paul Lopez, and the entire South Florida gay community. Lives in Fort Lauderdale, Florida, and works at the movie theater, and in case any of you all need free tickets. It's okay, put your hands together, looking very beautiful and debonair. That is contestant number 16, Lewis Nicholson. Well, that was it. We got one more category. We're about to name our top five in a little bit. Did y'all enjoy Farmerware? Y'all act like it. I don't know. Where Jim at? Where's Jim? Jim, maybe you need to keep me on the mic, because this is the most excitement I heard all night. They excited. Did y'all go to the bar on intermission? Is that what it was? Okay, then. I knew it was something. Y'all should have had something at the bar. I'm sorry? Okay. Is he ready? This is my good brother. Let's put our hands together for the singing talents of Mr. Tony DeSario.
You can dance every dance with the guy who gives you the eye. Let him hold you tight. You can smile every smile with the man and hold your hand in the pale moonlight. But don't forget who's taking you home and in whose arms you're gonna be. Oh, darling, save the last dance for me. Oh, I know that the music's fine, like sparkling wine. Go and have your fun, laugh and sing. But while we're apart, don't give your heart to anyone. And don't forget who's taking you home and in whose arms you're gonna be. Oh, darling, save the last dance for me. Baby, don't you know I love you so? Oh, I feel it when we touch. Baby, don't you know I need you so? Oh, I love you oh so much. You can dance, go and carry on till the night is gone and it's time to go. If he asks, if he can take you home, you must tell him no. Oh, no, no, no. Cause don't forget who's taking you home and in whose arms you're gonna be. Oh, darling, save the last dance for me. your cue to yell, by the way. How we doing, Chicago? Then and don't they do taking you home, and in whose arms you're gonna be. Oh, darling, say the last dance for me. No, baby, don't forget who's taking you home, and in whose arms you are gonna be. Say the last dance for me. Say the last dance for me. Say the last dance for me.
Ladies and gentlemen, he crowned me. That was Mr. Tony DeSario.
Thank you.
Let's keep this show rolling, ladies and gentlemen. It's because of this individual that I'm on stage singing opera. I didn't think that we would accept it, but he started it all for me right on this stage as Mr. Continental 2004. This is none other than Mr. Antonio Edwards. Put your hands together for Antonio. Ladies and gentlemen, that was Mr. Antonio Edwards. My mother was down there smiling. You must have got to her a little bit. Put your hands together for Miss Tommy Ross, who's a judge. Put your hands together for my mama. Ooh, That liquor wearing off. Is the bar still open? Well, Tony, could you move so some people can get to the line, please? Let me leave Tony alone. You ready?
I'm ready.
All right.
All right. You know, our judges always do such a good job, and I always never, half the time, I never watch the contest till I get the video, and then I know how good a job they've done. But I'd like to get a nice round of applause for them. Mr. Brian Reams from Chicago, we'd like to give him a nice round of applause there. Mr. Dennis Sobel from Cleveland, Ohio. Mr. Antonio Edwards, a former Mr. Continental from New York. In the back row, we have the owner of the complex in St. Louis, Missouri, Mr. Howard Meyer. The guy in the center takes more abuse than everybody, and he's one of the greatest judges there are around. From Boardman, Ohio, Mr. Skip Mackle, our head judge. Next to him is a guy I'm not really crazy about sometime, but, you know, I sit in his chair and get my hair cut and other things done to it. And sometimes he's in a talking mood, so it takes a long time. But he's done a great job, Mr. Robbie Hand from Salon 1800. He's been written up several times as one of the young designers in Chicago. So if you don't have a hairstylist, he is taking some new clients, okay? And, of course, next to him is a lady that is probably one of my dearest friends. And when I'm ever in trouble or I need to have something answered or just somebody to talk to me, she's the one who does it, Miss Tommy Ross, the former Miss Continental. So let's have a nice hand for her. Now, we're just waiting on the top five, but while we're doing it, all 10 of these guys should be the winner of Mr. Continental, I think. So let's give them all a nice round of applause. They will be coming out in just a minute, so as soon as they're getting here. As I told you before, some of the upcoming preliminaries. Hawaii, October 10th, if anybody wants to go over to Waikiki. October 18th, Purple Angel in Detroit. November 6th, we'll be in Huntington, West Virginia. And if you've never been to Huntington, you want to go there. We have a fantastic time at Stonewall. Some of you never leave sober, but it's a really nice time after the contest. And, of course, Heart of America Continental here in Chicago, November 9th. Kentucky, November the 13th. Sin City for the first time in Las Vegas coming up November 16th. So you go out and gamble and stay at Harris or the Rio or wherever and gamble. January 17th, Missouri. And they have a great new casino down there. If you like to gamble, it's called the Lumineer. It's lovely. January 26th, Big D in Dallas. January 31st is Southeast Continental. February 6th is Virginia Icon. February 14th is Florida State. And February 24th is North and South Carolina. But there was one in December, too. Indiana, isn't it in December, Jason Sadie? What date? The 3rd, Indianapolis at Talbot Street? Okay, Miss Indiana Continental, plus delete, right, or plus? So Indianapolis is a great place to go to if you haven't been there. Go to Elmo's for dinner. I hope they're getting here soon. Don't forget the show is going on at the Baton. If you want to go down tonight, our very special guest is Tysha Long, a former Miss Continental. Simba, can't you come up and talk a little more? He's better talk. You get him talking, he don't stop, buddy. Really does. We should have had another entertainer there, I think, but because I'm running out of things. I mean, I can stand up here and talk, but I don't want to bore you. I mean, I could talk about our ball teams. They went right down the drain this year, the White Sox and the Cubs. Let's hope the Bears do something better. Go Cardo. Oh, you had to say that, didn't you? You know, Brian was very merciful today. He didn't bring up the Missouri beat Illinois so bad. So, but our Northwestern team won today. Notre Dame won, so. Isn't that right? All right. Right, Steve? Notre Dame won big, did they? I mean, Northwestern won big, too, did they? How'd Marshall do tonight in West Virginia? They opened up tonight, too. Isn't this nice, gay men talking sports? They all thought we were still season only go to fashion shows. But we really do like sports. How was the art show today? Did you go to an art show or just looking at art today in Wilmette? Huh? Oh, you were buying. Oh, all right. You know, there's a young woman tomorrow night I'm going to bring on stage to introduce to you. I wish she was here tonight because you would all get a real charge out of this. As you know, we always put our tickets on sale on July 9th for Miss Continental at 1 o'clock. And all of a sudden at 1:01 in the afternoon, we got this long-distance call from the operator. And I said, I'm not taking any call from Afghanistan. They said, oh, no, you don't have to take a call. They're calling from Afghanistan. I said, you got to be kidding. One of our regular ladies at Continental was in the service in Afghanistan, and she's going to be home for Labor Day, and she's going to make sure to get in the call to get her tickets so she would be in the audience. And yesterday I was talking to her at the office. It just blew me away that this lady cared that much about coming to the contest that she called all the way from Afghanistan. So I'm going to introduce you to her tomorrow. Wonderful lady, a little butcher than I am, but, you know. Danielle still here? Danielle, why don't you come and take a bow? Let them see how lovely you look on while we're still on time. I can't cuss, so, you know, come on up here. Danielle says, oh, Jim's here, I can't cuss tonight. Well, she keeps betting a drink that she's not going to, and then all of a sudden, towards the end of the night, she might slip one or two nights. But when you go to Orlando, always stop in to see Danielle. It's always wonderful to see these girls come back. Dominique Chappelle's there too, isn't she? Dominique, why don't you come up and take a bow? Any of the other Continental girls that are here, come up and take a bow. I have to take some time here. I should have gone back there and worked that computer myself. Let's give Danielle Hunter, former Miss Continental, a nice round of applause there. All right, still looking lovely. And she's working and she's going to school every day now, 4 days a week. And here's Dominique Chappelle. Let's give Dominique a nice round of applause. All right. And of course, Coco was up here earlier, so otherwise we'd bring her back up. She's got a lot to tell you. But, and Michelle, I know you only want to get up here and start laughing, right? Screaming. She did that the night she was crowned. I thought she was dying up there, but she was understood her natural scream. Simba, can you come up and relieve me a minute? I can go see what's going on here. Oh. So usually, now Tony wanted to talk earlier. Now he's nowhere around either. Oh, why don't you get up here and talk, Tony, a minute? You're never
long. Okay, I'm done. Here you go.
Okay, gentlemen, once again, if I call your number, we'd like you to move forward, and then we'll put you back in order so the judges will have it down. Our first finalist tonight is contestant number 16, Lewis Nicholson. Our second finalist is contestant number 10, Leo DeMar. Our third finalist is contestant number 9, Christopher Iman. Our fourth finalist tonight is DeAndre Bonet, contestant number 15. And one more finalist can join this group, ladies and gentlemen. But once again, let's give them all a round of applause before they leave. And our fifth finalist is contestant number 7, Jose Perez. Judges, for your consideration, it'll be 7, 9, 10, 15, and 16. 7, 9, 10, 15, and 16. All right. First of all, we're going to say goodnight to Lewis. Lewis, you wait. They'll get you out the booth. And next, Neandre, you can leave us for a minute, okay? Next, number 10, you can leave us tomorrow for... You're much more professional than your mother, I have to tell you. And then we have to let Christopher Iman go for a minute. And then I need another microphone. Do we have another microphone? And Billy, let me know when they're all back there and locked up. Trusty.
Thank you.
Jose, how you doing?
Wonderful.
Wonderful?
Having so much fun.
Huh? Did you want an interpreter? Or do you?
Yeah, I would love to, just for the question.
Okay,
I
Paul Lopez.
I'll try to do my best.
We need our translator, Paul Lopez. Even though a lot of these contestants are taking English, they feel comfortable having it said to them in Spanish so they don't make a mistake. And this question can make or break you. Paul, I'll give you mine. Okay. Okay, I will read it to you once, and then Paul will read it to you. You take a little time, think about it, and then answer it, okay?
Perfect.
Jose, what is one thing you have learned about yourself through competing in this contest? What is one thing you have learned about yourself through competing in this contest? Now, Paul.
Thank you. La pregunta dice, ¿cuál es la cosa que has aprendido compitiendo en esta competencia? ¿Qué has aprendido compitiendo en esta competencia? Una cosa.
Once again, good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and distinguished panel of judges. Thank you, Jim, for the question. Thank you for the translation. I'm going to try to do my best with my English. One thing that I learned from this competition is being me all the time. It's being so proud of where I come from. It's being original. And respect all of the comments that people are being giving to me, and I want to
appreciate
this moment to say thank you to all of these people that's been helping me on this. Thank you.
All right, contestant number 7, Jose. All right. Are you going to give him the mic, Chen?
Yeah.
Okay. All right, Christopher Iman. How you doing?
I'm doing great, Jim.
You're doing good?
Yeah.
Okay, I'm going to read it to you twice. Chris, what is the one thing you have learned about yourself through competing in this contest? What is one thing you have learned about yourself through competing in this contest?
Good evening, ladies, gentlemen, and distinguished panel of judges, for your approval as well as your consideration.
I'm your male contestant number 9, and my name is Christopher Iman. In response to the question, the one thing that I've learned is that as long as I give my personal best and I stay true to myself, regardless of the outcome, I'm always a winner. But let me tell you, real quickly, I'm the only contestant that has competed 5 times in a row. And yes, even though that I felt I've given my personal best, and being a winner is still a great thing, it sure would be nice if judges you think would already know, and that's I'm the best candidate for this job for 2009-2010, so I can come out the winner. All I need for you to do is think what I already know, and I am the one. And not only do I plan to show up, but I plan to show out. And Jim, I promise you, if they call my name tonight, you won't be disappointed. Judges, your choice won't be in vain. And ladies and gentlemen, I will keep entertaining you every day for the next 365 days. Thank you. Ladies and gentlemen, I'm your finalist number 2, contestant number 9, Christopher Iman. Thank you.
All right, Chris. You know, these questions get harder, and they seem to come through with the right answers all the time. And everybody said, why do you have the question? And, you know, I think if you watched The View and you watched Candace Cain when they were trying to make her say something that she didn't want to say, she beat him around the bush and answered just what she wanted and came out the better person. I don't know if you all knew it. Candace was a former Miss Continental, and she was on the Dirty Sexy Money with William Baldwin. And you had Michelle Dupree and Flawless, and you had a few of the rest of them in Wu Tu Fong or Fong Wu Fu or whatever it was with Patrick Swayze. But that's why the questions are so very, very important. And one of our performers had even taken to Japan for 2 weeks and went on Japan TV for 2 weeks. So they have to learn to talk and be a little educated and can do it. And right now we're going to go on with contestant number 10. Leo. How you doing, Leo?
Good so far.
Good so far? Okay. I'm going to read this to you twice, then you take off on it, okay?
Thank
you. Leo, what is one thing you have learned about yourself through competing in this contest? What is one thing you have learned about yourself through competing in this contest?
Thank you, Jim. I want to take this time to thank God and to thank these judges for allowing me to come thus far. One thing I've learned about myself while competing in this contest is that I now know that I can be a lot more humble when I'm around more people. Like I said previously, I tend to come off as cocky and as arrogant. But now I learned while competing for Mr. Continental that I can come off as being humble if I just sit back, relax, take my time, and do what I have to do. Thank you.
Thank you, Leo. All right. 2 more to go, and then in 5 minutes we will have your winner for you. It's been a great bunch of guys, hasn't it? All night long. Very entertaining, very talented. Next year, Antonio's entering. And now we're here with DeAndre. DeAndre, how are you feeling?
I'm great. How are you?
I'm doing good. I'm going to read this question to you twice, and then you just take your time and answer it the best you can, okay? DeAndre, what is the one thing you have learned about yourself through competing in this contest? What is one thing you have learned about yourself through competing in this contest?
Thank you, Jim. The one thing that I've learned about myself through competing in Continental, this is my 3rd year, so obviously what I've learned is I'm good, but I can be better. Every year I've come back, I've learned and I've consulted with people, the formers, I've consulted with my supporters, I've consulted with my preliminary owners, And I spoke with them and found out, you know, what it is that was missing on the year that I'd win. And I've learned that, you know, me making it into the top five was an indication that I have the capabilities to one day be Mr. Continental, but I needed to improve, come back, and show the judges, as well as the Continental Pageantry supporters, that it's my time to shine. And over those 3 years, I've grown into an individual who not only wants to be Mr. Continental, but who also needs to be Mr. Continental and understands what it means to be Mr. Continental. So when I am Mr. Continental, and I will be, I'm going to show you, judges, that you made the right decision. I'm ready. Thank you.
DeAndre! And I don't know if I could answer this as good as some of them have done. I really don't. And now we have Mr. Lewis Nicholson.
Hi.
How you doing, Lewis?
Speechless.
Speechless? I don't believe that, but I've never known you to be speechless, but... I'm going to read this to you twice, and then you can take off and answer it, okay? Mm-hmm. Lewis, what is the one thing, you have learned about yourself through competing in this contest? What is one thing you have learned about yourself through competing in this contest?
One thing I have learned about myself in competing in this contest is that I am a very determined person. I don't know how many of you were here in the first year of the contest when 12 men decided that they wanted to be Mr. Continental. I was one of those people. The year that Tony DeSario won the contest, I was here as Mr. Florida, and I was very excited. I felt Continental. I didn't make it top five. The following year, I was here, Simba won the contest. I didn't make top 12, and I said to myself, I am going back because one day I will be Mr. Continental. I prepared myself thoroughly for this contest, and tonight I feel that because of my determination, I am standing here giving an answer to this question.
Thank you, Lewis. All right. All right. All right, we have just a couple more entertainers here, and then we're going to name our winner. So ladies and gentlemen, and when we get ready to name our winner, we'd like all of our promoters to come on stage with us, all of our performers. To get ready for that, okay? So right now, ladies and gentlemen, let's have a nice hand for former Mr. Continental, Simba Hall.
This is the moment, this is the day, when I spend all my doubts and demons on their way. Every endeavor I have made ever is coming into play, is here and now today. This is the moment, this is the time, where the momentum and the moment are in rhyme. Give me this moment, this precious chance. I'll gather up my past and make some sense at last. This is the day. See it sparkle and shine when all I've lived for becomes mine. For all these years I've faced the world alone, but now the time has come to prove to them I've made it on my own. Thank you, Chicago.
Thank you. I know the time is drawing now, and you are ready to see a new Mr. Continental 2009-2010. But before we do that, we have to pay homage to the reigning Mr. Continental, who did a phenomenal job. Let's put our hands together. He goes by the name of David Freckles Hunter. Put your hands together for David.
makes things feel all right. Belief makes things true. Things like you, you and I. Tonight you arrested my mind when you came to my defense with a knife in the shape of your mouth, in the form of your body, with the wrath of a god. Oh, you stood by me. Belief builds from scratch, doesn't have to relax. It doesn't need space. Long live the queen, and I'll be the king and the cholera grace. Oh, tonight you rest in my mind when you.
Okay, I woke up in heaven today. She kissed me, I floated away. Never felt anything so great.
Mr. Continental David Freckles Ruiz. And now, ladies and gentlemen, we all of our promoters of the Join Us on Stage. We're going to get our top five and pick our winner right now. All right, ladies and gentlemen, here is the time. Let's give all five of them a nice round of applause. We will only name the second, the first, and the winner, okay? So be courteous, give them all a round of applause. Our second finalist tonight, ladies and gentlemen, is contestant number 15, Neandre. And please do let them get pictures for you, Rush. Our first finalist tonight is contestant number 16, Louis Nicholson. And ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Continental 2010, Christopher Iman.